Romans chapter 7, verse 18, King James Version. Y'all ready?
Amen.
1, 2, 3, go.
For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwell a no good thing, for to do is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find not.
Amen. 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 Amplified Version says, for I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot perform it. I have the intention and urge to do what is right, but no power to carry it out. Amen? Amen. For the sake of this sermon and to better understand it and where I'm going, in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7. When you get there, say, I made it over. Amen, amen, amen. Y'all quit tonight. In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness. Y'all can join in. Forgiveness of his sins according to the riches of his grace. Can we repeat that from the top? In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. Somebody say, why are you going down, grace? You may be seated. You may be seated. Amen. Pastor Frizzlet, I thank you for this opportunity for tonight. I thank God who's my Lord and Savior. Amen. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I want to talk very briefly, if I can. That in a situation that there are some people tonight in a situation right now where can't nobody save you but God.
Come on now.
Whoa.
Come on now.
We've been hearing all night, been praying all night. Save me from me. Nobody can save you but God.
Come on, preacher.
Even getting here tonight was not easy. But nothing but the grace of God got you here. Since we are here tonight, if possible, we can take for a thought that for every victory, there is a story.
Come on.
And to every story, there is a process. I'm going to repeat that. That for every victory, there is a story. And to every story, there is a process. It is important to know, ladies and gentlemen, that nothing happens by accident. The Bible tells us in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, ladies and gentlemen, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I adorned thee a prophet unto the nation. Understand that before you knew it was going to be hell getting here tonight, God had already saw it. Before you knew that you was going to be messed up, God had already saw it. Come on, y'all. Y'all ain't talking about to me. Before you knew that you was going to have some sleep, that you was going to have some sleepless nights, God had already saw it. Before you knew that your life was going to be turned off, God had already saw it. Yes. Before you was even thought of, God already knew there was going to be some people lying on you, scandalizing your name, mistreating you, turning their backs on you, and becoming your worst, and you becoming your worst enemy at some point in your life. Yes. But God said, I already saw it coming. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever been in a place in your life where you felt like you just left the emergency room because of spiritual trauma you encountered in your life? And when you look around, you see other people laughing and questioning your faith, asking, where is your God? Why would your God allow you to face these type of obstacles knowing he has all power to bring you out? Y'all not participating, so I'm going to take my time. Have you ever been in a place where the problems in your life grew worse than you expected? Y'all not hearing me? Even more so, you have felt like life itself was not worth living. Y'all not talking about to me. You knew that you would experience problems, Sister Deborah, but you did not know at this point in your life where it would be traumatic and you become your worst enemy. Y'all not hearing me? The time, this time, it ain't your boo. Y'all not talking back to me. This time, it ain't your family. This time, it ain't your boss. Come on, talk back to me. This time, it's not your spiritual leaders. This time, it's not the rude people at your favorite restaurant. That's me. This time, it's not your friends. But more importantly, y'all, it is you. Y'all not talking back to me. Y'all not talking back to me. I wish I had a church that could talk back to me. How did your personal life trauma affect you? That's what you got to ask yourself. Did it cause you to become suicidal? Yes, I'm talking about somebody here. Did it cause you to become bitter? Yes. Did it cause you to give up on relationships? Talk back to me, somebody. Did it cause you to hate yourself? Come on, y'all. Did it cause you to have some sleepless nights? Did it cause you to become angry? Yes, 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 yes. Did it cause you to become upset with God? Come on, y'all. Did it cause you to neglect your loved ones? Or did it cause you to ask God to save me?
Yes,
Lord. Many of us in this room tonight, ladies and gentlemen, are wounded spiritually, mentally, and physically.
Yes.
Many of us feel like that our spirit man are in shackles. Yes, Lord. There are a group of people in this sanctuary right now. Well, you can relate to Psalms 142, verse 7. Yes. Where it says, bring my soul out of prison. Yes. That I may praise thee. But we can't because the place that you have gone, it crippled you spiritually. Talk back to me, somebody. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. And when you walk around like you got it all together, but the reality is that you can't even be creative anymore because of hurt, disappointment, stress, and neglect. You can't be creative. One of the most interesting things to note is that people see the oil in your life. Yes, they do, but they don't know the cost. They see the smell, but they don't know the cost.
My God!
They see you preaching and singing your heart up unto God, but they don't know the cost.
Yeah, you better believe it's a cost.
But they don't have no idea the cost you had to pay in order to get to this place tonight. Yes. Some of us in this room tonight can't even begin to explain to people what you had to go through to get to the place where you are today. Many of us are speechless, and the only thing that you can say, when I think of the goodness of Jesus, yes, and all that he has done for me, that's all you can say. Paul, ladies and gentlemen, wants us to know that while it is that when we pray on a daily basis, we fast on a daily basis, we pay our tithes constantly, we have revivals, we go to church, he wants us to know that through every process, misery will be present.
Oh.
Wow. Ooh. Y'all caught that?
You're right.
Y'all caught it?
Yeah.
He wants to know that everything that you go through, there will be misery present. Amen. Look at your neighbor, tell me, there will be misery present. It won't be easy, ladies and gentlemen. There are some challenges in your life that you're going to have to face, amen. There are some obstacles you are going to encounter. There are some storms in your life that you are going to make, that are not going to make things so clear. But look at your neighbor, tell him, that's all right. Look at your neighbor one more time and say, count it all joy. Count it all joy. Look at your other neighbor, find your another neighbor and tell him to count it all joy. Yes, Lord. Count it all joy. Look at your neighbor one more time and tell them, count it all joy, baby. Yes. In the book of Romans chapter 7, ladies and gentlemen, it is important for us to acknowledge three key words. Write it down. Y'all ready? This is Bible study.
Teach us, man.
First word. Y'all ready?
Yes, sir.
Holler back at me, some of y'all ready. Y'all ready? Y'all ready to go? Help the Lord. First word, law. Write that down. Law. Now, law and order, law. Law and order, law. Second word, sin. Third word, flesh. My note says, apostle says, in the book of Romans chapter 6, verse 14, for sin shall not be master over you.
Yes.
Wow.
For you are not under law, but under grace. Somebody holler back and say grace.
Grace!
Yes, Lord. That's what I like. Yes, Lord. First lady ready to go, y'all. It is awesome. Stop. It is awesome to know that when you mess up, God is still willing to keep you. Yes, he is. Even though you didn't do nothing to deserve it, God said, but my grace is what's going to keep you. Oh, y'all should have caught that right there. Let's talk about the law real quick. Can we talk about the law real quick, y'all? Can I be me? I'm going to be me doing this process right here. This is me. Y'all can hate me if y'all want to, but I love you regardless. The law. The law that Apostle Paul is referring to, ladies and gentlemen, is the Mosaic Law. This is what he's talking about, the Mosaic Law that was given to the nation Israel so through it they could be saved and be made right with God. Because this is why the law was given, because the people back then was ratchet.
That's right.
They was ratchet. They were sleeping around and committing adultery. This is what the Israelites was doing, y'all. They were killing people, just like what we see on the news today. They were stealing things that didn't belong to them and selling it on Madison and Cicero. This is what they was doing. They were telling false information about their neighbors, like they do on Real Housewives, Empire, and the Love and Hip Hop.
Are you messing with folks?
I don't watch none of them shows. Y'all watch them? Yeah. Lying. They were twerking and trying to give God some praise with the same body.
All right.
I don't even know what twerking is.
They were wearing leggings. This is what my note said. They were wearing leggings through the week, but wearing a holy dress on Sundays. I'm trying to relate. They were freezing and I were praying on the conference line in the next morning. Come on, y'all. Yes, they were. These were the things, ladies and gentlemen, that people had to deal with then and even up to now. But the Bible declares in Ecclesiastes chapter 1, verse 9, that there is nothing new under the sun. Come on, y'all. Apostle is using the law as an analogy and to let us know that the law was good, but it wasn't good enough to take us to glory. The law showed people what would happen if they went this way or if they went that way. Come on, y'all. It gave guidance, but did not force people to live by it. Yes. The law is not the problem. Understand that, y'all. The law is not the problem, but it is easily hijacked by our sin.